Welcome, folks, to one of my very favorite puzzle games. This is Nelson Tethers Puzzle Agent for the PC. This is not my first time through the game. You can see I have a save game right there, but this time I'm going to try to do it without any hints or out any failures. I did pretty well last time. Really, the charm of this game is in a few other things, as you're about to see. Alright, if you didn't take it all in, we are Nelson Tethers, a puzzle agent in the FBI's puzzle division. We are doing our normal thing of solving puzzles for the FBI when we were approached by apparently something horrifying in a spacesuit. Anyway, Nelson Tethers' crossword puzzle has been ripped to bits because, of course, he was having a fit. But is there something written on it? Reconstruct it to find out. This is how all the puzzles in this game are sort of structured. You have like a description, then you have the actual puzzle. Some of them have additional hints. Alright, let's see if we can puzzle-roo this out. These ones are pretty easy, the jigsaw ones, because you can really just slap things all over the place and it'll like pull itself into a position. It's kind of nice. These aren't too hard. They're just enjoyable little puzzles. I had a feeling that went there. And when it clicked in this form, I knew I was right. There we go. There we go. And there we are. Scoggins. You submit your answer, and we'll see if it's right. There you go. So you'll see the scoring here. You're deducted less for hints than you are for wrong answers. So if you're playing this game on your own, and I suggest that you do, you should use hints if you are truly stumped. It's better than a wrong answer.
Puzzle research. This is Agent Tethers. I think you have the wrong number. Oh, I see. An assignment. In the field? No, sir, it's been, yes, quite some time. Uh-huh. Erasers? The foundation of democracy? Oh, absolutely, sir, I agree, sir. Oh, yes, the White House needs its erasers, sir. I'll be on the next plane to... Wait, where?
Why'd the spaceman tell us to go to Scoggins and then have our supervisor tell us the same? What does it mean?
just arrived in Scoggins, Minnesota. Population, 754. Temperature, it's cold, and not much to look at. According to the agency, there's some kind of thing going on at the local eraser factory. The whole plant is shut down. There's a weird man staring at me. Hopefully, this won't be a big waste of time. Agent Tethers out.
That's right, DJ. I'm sure the spaceman's our supervisor.
Might have to ask for directions.
All right, so we need to talk to the creepy man. Also, to answer your question earlier there, DJ, he asked, do you watch the anime called Sokugeki no Soma? I think I've seen a few episodes of it. Isn't that the one with the cooking? I can't remember. He's looking at your butt, Tethers. Well, he certainly was looking at his back end. Let's talk to this creepy man.
Excuse me, I'm Nelson Tethers with the FBI's Department of Puzzle Research. Hello?
Yeah.
Okay, and you are?
Bjorn.
Bjorn?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Bjorn. Boy, those snowmobiles sure are a bumpy ride, eh?
Yeah.
The voice acting in this game is top-notch. I'm not even being facetious with that. I really mean it.
Can you give me directions to the nearest hotel? I'm having a little trouble finding my way around.
You'd never get there. Roads are too slick.
Sir, I'm an agent of the FBI's Puzzle Research Division. It can't be harder than the puzzles I see every day.
Not so.
It's really just a matter of trajection.
Okay, on the way to the hotel, you're going to pass two traffic lights.
Nelson's snowmobile is sliding along the roads. Arrange the logs to help Nelson bump his way to the hotel. Make sure to pass the traffic lights Bjorn mentioned along the way. Alright. So it tells us the mechanics. You can drag the logs into place. When he hits the log, he goes 90 degrees depending on the orientation of the log. It's pretty easy. On this one, we must hit every stoplight on the way. That's important. So here are the stoplights. We need to pass through these squares is what it means. So we can go ahead and do this. We can do this. So he's going to go bing, 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 bing. That's where we ultimately need to go. Ding, 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 ding. And there you go. Now, we already know we did, even though we submitted to, you know, the Department of Case Processing and Verification. It's one thing that's nice about these Find Your Path puzzles. Right now, the game is starting up pretty slow. That's, you know, that's just good design. How? Just in case you want to know how that actually is the solution, in case you fumbled for the answer, well, now you can. See?
I must have gotten lost. I thought your directions were taking me to the hotel.
They did.
I'm standing in front of the hotel, aren't I?
Yeah.
Thanks a lot.
Welcome.
Couldn't figure that out, could you, puzzle man? Well, let's talk to him.
I'm here to investigate an incident at the Scoggins Eraser Factory. Do you know anything about it?
Nope. The hotel's going to close soon. Better check in if you're sneaking around.
Stop talking to me, dammit.
Seen any suspicious people hanging around the hotel lately?
Yep.
Really? Can you describe them?
Skinny. Asks lots of questions. Wears a stupid hat.
Thanks for the tip.
Yep.
Love this guy's hair, by the way. It looks like he's built for speed. Alright. You can also click anywhere on the screen, and it'll show you where things are. So, like, we have this.
Discovered a fence. Boards all chewed up, something terrible. Could be the work of strays trying to get to the dumpsters back there.
Yes, strays.
I don't know why I'm reporting this.
Those are pretty big, I guess, bite marks. I'm guessing they're probably not strays, but maybe bears? This is Minnesota. Should have bears, right? An interesting place we stumbled into. Let's go and talk to you.
Hello there, mister. Welcome to Valda's Inn. I'm Martha Garrett, but everyone calls me Ma. How can I help you?
I'm Nelson Tethers. I have a reservation.
Oh, yeah. You're here about the eraser factory, eh? We're awfully excited to have a real FBI man in our town. It's just like TV, yeah? Ooh, I'm gonna make some hot dish for you later.
A hot dish?
Oh, you'll love it. I've never met a man who didn't love himself some hot dish.
Ah, yes. The nebulous hot dish. All right. Well, let's ask about our room key.
What room am I in?
Yeah, okay. I've got your room right here. Oh, dear. This is so embarrassing. The night clerk wrote down your room number in code.
Of course.
Mind if I have a look? I bet I can figure out what room.
Kind of a thing that I do. The security-minded night clerk notated Nelson's room number in a cryptic form. Help Martha see what's written so you can get your keys. All right. As I understand this, this puzzle used to be a little more obtuse, but, I mean, you can kind of see it. Just look for the letters. We have an N, an I, an N, and an E. So the answer is 9. This isn't a big town, and this isn't a big hotel. Ald loves the Minnesota accent. And there you go. Not really much of a code, but you know.
There you go, Mrs. Garrett.
Oh, yeah, now I see. Okay then, here's your room key, FBI man.
Thanks. Actually, while I have you here, do you mind if I ask you a couple questions? Real quick, I promise.
Oh, yeah, of course.
All right.
How do I get to the factory from here?
The FBI doesn't know where the factory is? Oh dear, our moose is cooked.
Rest assured, ma'am, the FBI just likes to confirm intelligence with civilian knowledge of... We like to double-check things.
Oh, of course. Well, it's easy. I have a tourist map of our little town of Scoggins right here.
Is it in one piece?
You know, our Scoggins erasers is the plant that supplies the White House with all of its erasers. The president could be fixing a mistake with a Scoggins eraser right now.
Yes, ma'am. That's why I'm here. That and the fact that every time the Bureau made an inquiry into the situation, all we ever got back were bizarre puzzles.
Oh, yeah. Well, that'll happen.
That'll happen. Yep.
Anything about the problem at the factory?
Yeah, so tragic about the accident, huh?
Accident?
Oh, yeah, the foreman, Isaac Davner, they say he was killed in there.
Is that so?
Well, not to be gossipy, but I heard the accident was caused by raccoons.
Raccoons?
Yeah, little creatures that live in the woods around the factory. Maybe you should go talk to Sheriff Bogg about it, though. You should be able to catch him out by the factory right now.
Okay, I'll do that. Thank you.
After we get a few more puzzles.
The guy in the lobby, is he okay?
Oh, that's Bo Murphy. He's always been a bit of an odd one. Yeah, he sits there all day trying to do his puzzles. He mostly keeps to himself, and I bring him some food from time to time. Sometimes I swear he'd starve to death if I didn't bring him something to eat.
Of course. Well, goodbye.
Well, goodbye.
Enjoy your stay.
Oh, that reminds me. Do you have any gum for sale? Or know where I can buy some?
Dear, we've been out of gum for quite some time.
What?
Haven't seen a stick in months anywhere in town. We tend to get shipments of things like that in the spring.
So, no gum?
Nope.
Gum helps me concentrate.
It's a big, big deal. And now we learn about, well, one of the darker sides of Nelson here. He's a fucking addict! Gum found. Nelson Tethers thinks best when he's chewing gum. Any kind of gum. Find discarded gum and use it to get a hint during a sticky puzzle. We're really just doing our best to clean up this town, right? Let's talk to this crazy guy here.
You look perplexed.
Puzzles. So many puzzles.
Puzzles? I might be able to help you with that.
Now this one gave me, I think this was one of my failed answers the first time, and it's really not that hard, because I didn't know what the hell the game wanted me to do. Anyway, Bo has swallowed a rubber band again. His x-ray shows only tapeworms, or does it? Rotate the segments of the pesky parasites to reveal the hidden object. I'm all, what hidden object am I trying to reveal? You just need to make a loop. You just need to make a loop with all these little critters. That's all that matters. And my goodness, it was so fucking annoying when I did that the first time. Well, what do you want from me, damn it? Oh. It's pretty interesting the way this is built out, because it is, like, perfect. Alright, that looks like the one we need. You'll see it's one continuous loop. And we have all these guys. This one's got two heads, wacky guy. You can't work that way. Not a problem. Don't worry, folks. It will get harder.
Relax a little.
The whispers. It's an acrostical enigma. Maybe it's a Baltimore transdeletion. The whispers.
Or not.
The whispers. I hear them. Anyway, we had another puzzle-roo over here. Let's check it out.
Well, these are interesting.
Yeah, those are Scoggins gnomes. All the tourists love them. But I think one has gone missing. I swear, I had six of them. I took a picture when I set it up, but I guess I lost it. I still have the film negative, though.
Of course. You don't have the photo. You have the negative. Of course, you gotta make this complicated. Alright, a ceramic gnome has disappeared from the hotel display. But which gnome? Identify the gnome in Martha's photo negative. That doesn't appear in the display. Alright, this one you have to be... you have to pay attention to the details. We have three with red hats. This is the display, this is the negative, clearly. So we have all the ones with red hats. So ignore the green ones, they're all there. We only need to pay attention to these ones with red hats, because it's a negative, remember? Alright, so we have one guy looking towards an upraised hand, and one guy looking away from an upraised hand. Let's see. These guys are both looking at an upraised hand right here. That guy's looking away, so he's here. That's that guy. We don't have to worry about him. It's you. We need to figure out... which one of these assholes is you? So if it was a negative, he'd be flipped onto the other side, right? So this one would be him. So that means it's you who's missing. Just double checking here. Make sure I'm not full of shit. Pretty sure it's you. Not exactly sure what that's made with, by the way. It looks like I just took out a can of shaving cream and went, "This is your guy right here. Book him, Lou." I'm pretty sure that's it. Let's double check, because I'd hate to fail. You actually get an additional puzzle, as I understand it, if you do all this without failing. And I'd like that. Yeah, let's go with that. Da-da-da! No chance. Negative gnomes. Spelled g-negative. How clever.
Well, one of your gnomes has most definitely run off.
No shit. Wouldn't that be something? She already knew that, Tethers. Now she knows which one, I suppose. Anything back here? Oh, we have a puzzleroo down there. Let's see what the puzzler is. Winner undeclared in local contest. Let's see. Annabelle Grill. The Annabelle Grill ladies arm wrestling. A tournament is over, and the judge missed it. Read the four statements and help them determine the winner. This one's actually a pretty decent logic puzzle. All right, so there were four competitors, clearly, which means we had... I can't remember. Well, there were three matches in total. We had, it could have been like one versus you versus you, you versus you, and then the winners of those two bouts had to have the championship arm wrestle. So she was outmatched by the Grizzly Grip. We know it wasn't her who won. Pat won fair and square. Let's see. I pinned Pearl just like a hat. And we have Flo's Grizzly Grip. Couldn't whip me. So we know she won at least one. And you won at least one, too. Let's see. I know who the winner is already, to be perfectly honest. But I'm trying to explain the logic of why it is again. Let's see. Pat won fair and square. I'm trying to figure out, because I think when I first did, I determined it was like you or you. And it's kind of impossible to figure out whose name is what. Ah, yes. Okay, so we know she was in the final match because the Grizzly Grip beat at least one person, right? So, the person who was not defeated by the Grizzly Grip is the winner. There you go. So it's her. And that's the logic behind why. Took me a long time to just like sort that one out when I first did it. Because I was so busy trying to figure out whose name was who. It's actually a lot simpler than that. Like it says, a four-person tournament means there are three matches. The first two matches and the competitors are eliminated. The final match, two winners are faced off. The winner was the champion. Flo, the wielder of the Grizzly Grip, won one match and lost another. That's the only that's only possible if she won the first match and proceeded to the final match and lost. The woman who beat the Grizzly Grip is the winner. My logic exactly.
That was a tricky one.
That was fairly tricky. Not this time, because of course, like I said before when I started this, I played this game before. And flat. Yes, it's a meaningless screwdriver. It's not a point-and-click game, even though it sort of has a point-and-click architecture? Yeah.
The residents of Skagen seem nice enough. Aside from one wild goose chase, everyone's been cooperative. Plus, it looks like I'm primed for all the hot dish I can eat. It remains to be seen if that's a good thing. I got a map from the hotel owner, so I'm heading over to the eraser factory. Agent Tethers out. Am I supposed to be saying that?
You know, that reminds me of yesterday when I was watching Grimmoth and SKS stream. It makes me think that hot dish is most likely a euphemism. Also, if you didn't see the stream, just know that Grimma's mother is still very healthy. Interpret that the way you will. You may actually be right as to what's transpiring. Anyway, let's select the factory. Alright, so here we have Sheriff Bog.
Sheriff Bog? Yeah, I'm Nelson Tethers.
Look at that look.
FBI's Department of Puzzle.
Agent Tethers, good to meet you. We got a real mess here. Yes, we do.
We do?
Oh, yes. It's gonna be a while before we can get this factory running again.
But my job is to get this factory back to making erasers.
Agent Tethers, you're in a right pickle.
Well, I should probably ask you some questions about the incident, then.
That's what I'd do if I was a big, important FBI boy.
This guy over here. Also, it sounds like he has some congested sinuses, the way he talks.
was this incident?
Well, we don't need to be dramatic.
What happened?
There was an explosion.
What?
Oh, yeah. A big explosion. And the foreman just never came home.
It didn't look like there's an explosion, but okay. Let's do a puzzle room.
When did the accident take place?
Well, I've been trying to figure that out myself. Here's what I know.
The Rest Easy Guard Service was employed to keep watch over the factory from midnight to midnight yesterday. From their statements, can you determine the time of the big noise? Well, let's see. Alright, so boom! 1 hour before the last shift. Boom, right 1 hour before the last shift started. And then we have, I get the shortest shift. 3 hours. Only Bernie put in a full 8 hours.
I worked from six till I was relieved.
We have Bernie, we have Pop, we have Al, we have Iggy. Well, it's clear who heard the actual fucking explosion. It's Bernie here. Boom. You know who did it. You need to know when, though. And it covered the whole 24-hour period. I'm actually going to get my notepad because it'll make this a bit faster. All right. So I don't have the exact answer on here. We're still going to have to figure out what it was. Let's see, I have one shift from 1 to 9, one from 9 to 12, and one from 12 to 6, and then 6 to 1. Okay, I think that means that Iggy was 6 to 1. Yeah. So let's see, from our information, we know when Iggy started. It had to be 6 a.m. or it had to be 6 p.m. And I think I just settled on it being 6. No, I have 6 a.m. on here. All right. We also know that Bernie here had a third shift because it was 1 hour before the last shift started. So we know that. If we can determine when the third shift was, we can figure out, you know, the neighborhood of when it was. All right, so I have midnight to 6, 6 to 1. All right, I'm pretty sure it was at 8. Pretty sure it was at 8 p.m. Looking at this. Yeah. Because we know that Bernie worked 8 hours. So I determined that you worked 7 hours, right? I'm not exactly sure how I did that. We just know that you worked 8 hours, and I think the arithmetic with when Iggy started kind of determined that. So when, like, Al, Iggy, Bernie, Pop. Pop closed up shop. See? So we're going to go with 8 o'clock. Pretty sure that's when it was. I'll read there how, and he'll explain it a little bit better. That was, like, the abbreviated version. There you go. Bam. Thankfully, I kept around my notepad. That made this much, much easier. So here you go. Bernie worked 8 hours out of the 24-hour day. Pop worked only 3. Al worked 6 hours, and Iggy worked 7. You can kind of determine, well, there's 11 hours there, so you know the other guys have to work some combination of 13. And since Iggy worked, I'm not exactly sure how I determined that, but either way, Iggy had to start at 6 a.m. because he was relieved by another guard. Al came first and worked a 6-hour shift from midnight to 6. Then Iggy came in from 6 and ended at 1. Bernie worked third shift, since that's when he heard the noise, clearly. His shift went to 9 p.m., so the explosion had to be at 8, since he declared it to be an hour before the last shift, right? Right. There you go.
There was an explosion at that time. Wouldn't the icicles on the building have been knocked off?
Good point. Maybe they grew back.
They grew back just like weeds. Also, apparently Aventaro says he's been wanting to see this game for ages. That's good. I really like this game, and I hope you'll enjoy it too. Tell me about the foreman, Danvers.
What happened to the foreman? my notes don't have a lot of details.
Well, we're still trying to figure that out. One day after work, Mr. Dabner just never came home. The accident was pretty bad.
Oh, is there a body?
Nope. He's just gone. Isaac Dabner's his name, if you don't have that in your notes.
We don't even know if he died in that explosion?
Won't be able to find that out till we find a way into the factory.
Mm-hmm.
What did your investigation turn up?
Not much. Can't figure out how to get past this lock.
Well, that's because it's missing a piece. I can see that just by looking at it.
So it is. I guess that's why you make the big bucks, right?
That's
right, sir.
That's why I make the big bucks, because I'm not blind.
Well, I don't seem to be getting a lot of answers.
Listen, why don't you meet me down at the Moose Ear Diner later? I have some files related to the case that you might be able to help me with.
Oh, okay, but I really think...
Agent Tethers, it's a pleasure working with you. You're doing a great job. Meet you at the Moose Ear in a bit.
Off he goes, into the sunset. Indeed. So we can look at that again.
Interesting. Out at their eraser factory, the doors to the factory are very locked. Some sort of custom-built contraption has got this place locked up tighter than Fort Knox. The device seems damaged, though. It seems to be missing a piece.
Really, I think a crowbar or some other entry device would get in there... pretty much 5 seconds, but for the sake of, you know, gameplay, we'll go find the gear or whatever that's missing. Right? Right. All right, let's head to the Moose Ear Diner. Moose Ear Diner. There you go.
Hello.
What a talkative fellow. Lutefisk over there. Well, let's see what this fellow's doing.
Excuse me. I see you're working on your sign. Is it safe for me to go into the diner? Excuse me.
Gotta fix the sign.
All right. Maybe I can help.
Something wrong with your sign? I said, is there something wrong with...
You a cop. I ain't got time for cops.
I'm not a cop.
Technically, he is a cop.
Get this sign fixed before it gets dark. I don't want to be out here after dark, if you know what I mean.
I don't, actually. What do you mean by that?
It's just a fuse, but I can't remember which one it is. Not with all the whispers in the head.
What? Whispers?
Get the fuse for me. Getting cold out here.
The repairman has forgotten which fuse he needs to use, even though he coded them so he wouldn't forget. Select the fuse that completes the sequence. Alright. This one I was sort of pissed off at myself, because I've seen this puzzle before I even played this game. But I did use a hint on this when I first played the game. Because it's all what completes the sequence. I was like looking at the shapes, trying to figure out how they like coincide. No, it's much simpler than that. Just take like a piece of paper and cover up half of this button and you'll see kind of what the answer is. And then do it to this one and then do it to this one. You'll see what the answer is. The hint that I got, by the way, is it looks like something he was using. Because the answer is this. And you'll see why in just a moment. So each figure in the sequence is made up of the number and its mirror reflection. As you can see, that one's a 2. And they're joined together from the right to the left parts of the number. The missing number in the sequence is 3. 1, 2, 3, and of course the last one was 4. You got it, Zephyr. You're doing a good job.
What do you know? This ought to keep the little buggers away.
Little what?
Well, I gotta finish getting this sign mounted. See you later. We'll see.
What the fuck is that supposed to mean? And little buggers? What the hell is that? Anyway, you know anything about the factory?
I don't suppose you know anything about the eraser factory accident?
Don't suppose I do.
Well, shit.
Did you know Isaac Davner?
Not much. Heard he had some kind of accident. Feel bad for his wife, Glory. Such a pretty girl.
I should really talk to her. Do you know where I can find her?
Yes, I do.
So, where can I find her?
Inside.
Thanks.
Goodbye.
So we have quite a few people in here. Of course, we have Sheriff Bog. We have some stuff on the counter. What's this?
There's some tobacco on the counter. It smells like cherry. I guess the waitress hasn't been in much of a cleaning mood lately.
I know, he just says that right in front of her, right?
Excuse me, ma'am. Miss? Waitress lady?
Welcome to the Moose Ear Diner. I'll be right with you.
Can I help you with that?
Glory is distracted by the puzzle of food she's preparing to serve. Fit all the food items on the plate in such a way that none of them overlap to get her attention. This is another sort of jigsaw puzzle. I do like these. No, not like that. How do you fit? Do you fit? No. Oh, something clicked in the place. Yeah, you'll see, like, there, I didn't even mean to do that, but they have found their place, which is good. That one also found a place. You know, I like these, but they are a little broken. Just a bit. Fish, you can probably go somewhere. Oh, right there. Yeah, see? Connected with the asparagus. And ha-ha! Perfect. Pretty sure that bacon goes on the outside, probably. Who the hell ordered this? There's, like, way too much food. How doth you fit? You go around the cake? You do. Perfect. There you go. One plate of way too much food. Easy peasy.
There you go. Delicious.
Thanks.
So, what's good here?
I don't know. It's all fine.
Oh, okay. What's your name?
Glory Davner.
Oh, So, I'm Nelson. Are you feeling okay?
Yes. No, I'm just thinking about my husband.
What's wrong with your husband, ma'am? Is he okay?
He will be.
Well, I'm with the FBI's Department of Puzzles Research. I need to ask you a few questions.
All right, let's begin the questioning.
An accident at the eraser factory caused it to shut down. Do you know anything about that?
Of course I do.
What have you heard?
Well, nothing really. I mean, just that it was an accident, like everyone says.
Also, Sivarius ponders, I wonder if the amount he gets paid is a reference to anything, since it's $75,642.89. As far as I'm aware, no. It does double every time you fail. Or for each attempt, I should say.
The factory foreman, Isaac Davner. He was your husband?
Yes.
Oh, I'm so sorry. There's not much in my files about him.
That's okay. He's a great man. I'm so proud of him.
For?
Just so proud.
Oh, okay.
Repairman. The guy outside.
Seems a bit odd. Anything I should know about him?
Well, I think he's got a bit of a crush on me, but he's harmless.
Could he have hurt your husband to get to you?
Oh, no. He wouldn't hurt a fly. He even avoids stepping on rocks so he won't accidentally hurt any critters living below. I wish people wouldn't tease him for that, Daryl.
Tee. What a softie. Anyway, work?
Has the factory closure affected business?
Yeah. People tend to hang around here longer now that they aren't going to work. Normally, that'd be a good thing, but I've been pretty distracted.
I see that. Maybe I can help.
What puzzle do you have for us this time? When these three couples walked into the diner, Lori thought she knew what each would order. She was wrong, and now she's forgotten who gets what. Here's what she does recall. Nobody ordered a meal resembling their spouse. One lady ordered a meal resembling the fish-eating man sitting next to her. Let's see. Only one patron resembles his or her meal. The ham plate should be set down next to the banana split. I want to call it the banana split. Whatever. Alright, so we have all these dishes and all these hilarious people to serve them to. We have fish woman, a guy who looks like a buffalo, a guy with a funny hat, a chicken woman, an onion head, and this hog-faced woman. Alright, so... Oh, no. No. I want to read the rules. So... One lady ordered a meal resembling the fish-eating man next to her. Well, we know that none of them ordered a meal resembling their spouse, so I'm pretty sure that this woman has to be the one. So we know that she has something resembling the man, and he's eating fish. Right? Right. Let's see. Yep. One patron resembles his or her meal. Ham plate must be set down next to the banana split. Well, let's see if we can make the rules work. Just based on that. One patron resembles his or her meal. Well, let's say that banana guy resembles his meal. And that the ham plate needs to go next to that. Remember? Let's see. That's the spouse rule. Ham plate should be set down next to the banana split. Yes. And then the banana man will resemble his banana meal. So if we put down this here, and we put down this here, does it fit all the rules? First rule is, nobody ordered a meal resembling their spouse. Is that true? We have the ham, we have the chicken, none of that matters. It's good. One lady ordered a meal resembling the fish-eating man next to her. We have our chicken woman here, fish-eating man. There you go. One patron resembles his or her meal. Right there. And the final rule is, the ham plate should be set down next to the banana split. Which it is. Alright, let's see if we're right. Survey says, yes!
That wasn't so tough.
Yeah, I guess not.
Could I have a bit more of your time, ma'am?
Sure.
Actually, we're done here. Let's see who else is in here.
Hi there. I'm Agent Tethers with the FBI. Sir, you seem stressed. Do you know something about the factory you'd like to let me in on?
I don't know anything.
Sir, It's against the law to withhold information or lie to a federal agent.
I'm into some stuff.
Yeah, stuff and things.
So, what's your name?
Steve.
Sir, I'm here about the factory. If you've got nothing to do with it, then however you spend your time doesn't concern me.
Alright, tell me about the factory.
There's nothing you can tell me about the factory.
I don't co-mingle with the factory folk.
You haven't heard about anything suspicious going on, have you?
Nothing more than usual.
Alright, well tell me about this stuff.
What stuff are you into?
I airlift wooden gnomes out of Scoggins. With birds.
To where? Why? How?
Black market trinket rings. Big money.
Couldn't you just use the mail?
He does not answer. Loner Steve trains birds to transport freight. Tonight's shipment just departed, but Steve forgot to note the quantity. Can you determine the number of gnomes? Each type of bird has a certain weight limit. Each bird is shown carrying the maximum weight it can carry. Birds may team up on heavier loads, each carrying what he can. Freight must be balanced evenly between the bird's legs. So we can see, like, right here, that the blue bird, it only supports two gnomes. We don't know exactly how much this duck does. Alright, so bird, bird, bird. We know that this one supports only two, so we know that you only support two. That means there's got to be one in there. And it has to be evenly distributed. Alright. So if that's true, perhaps the mallard here can hold two himself, right? Or two on each leg with a total of four. So that would mean there's two in here, two for each mallard, so four. And then on this one, there would be another three, like this, and another one. So we have 1, 4, 6, 10, 13, 14. Right? 1, 3, 2, 4. Pretty sure that's right. I mean, it would be 12 without you, wouldn't it? 4, 10, 12. Yes, 14. That is my ultimate response. Huzzah! Not a big problem. I'm good at the maths. Eat it, puzzles.
How are you doing, Steve?
You got more puzzle ruse for us?
Out of curiosity, anything else you want to tell me about these birds?
They're smart. I once saw a black-bellied whistling duck open a car door and steal a cream cheese Danish.
Wow.
Loner Steve has an order of ceramic gnomes ready to ship, but here comes his avian mail carriers. Draw lines to attach freight to the bird legs, keeping in mind these rules. The rules are the same as last time, except it tells you the actual weight that each leg can carry. So the mallard can carry still two per leg, owls 1.5, and the bluebird can carry one. Birds may team up on heavier loads, of course, and they still need to be balanced. The lines cannot cross or the shipment will be tangled. That's important. So this one works a bit differently. We know that you can carry four, so it'd be something like this. Alright, so that means there's still three gnomes of unaccounted weight in there. So we could put it like this. That wouldn't be enough, though. We need you here, too. Aha, see? Alright, and then we have you guys. We know that you can pick up three and that you can pick up two with each leg. So if you went like that, I think that would suss it all out. Two for you, one for you, one for you. 3, 2, 2. Yes. Easy peasy. And none of those lines were crossing. Doesn't matter if they're crossing at the actual ring, by the way. As demonstrated.
Well, that wasn't so hard.
Alright. Do you have any more puzzles? You don't yet. He will later. You didn't have any other ones, did you?
Sure.
Okay, just making sure.
Hello, gentlemen. A bit early for a lunch break, isn't it?
Until the eraser factory opens again, Daryl and I have nowhere else to go.
Yeah, me and Daryl got nowhere else to go.
Oh, that's great. Then you don't mind if I ask you a few questions?
Yeah. As soon as I get these bugs back in place.
What?
What? Why do you have bugs in a diner?
You gonna help or not?
Never mind why they're here. You gonna help or not? Daryl's famous insect collection has gone AWOL. Box them back up again by string lines between the adjoining points, keeping in mind these rules. Enclose all the bugs using the fewest possible number of lines to draw a box possible. A box can be any size, but must be four-sided. Only rectangles and squares are allowed. Bugs of the same kind can share a box, otherwise, who knows? Maybe they make hybrid bugs if you don't do that. Each green grass grazer needs three squares of territory, including the square it's on. The pink puddle paddler needs two, including the square it's on. So you'll see, like, right here we have valid rectangles for each of them. This will make sense once we get going. All right. So these two, for instance, they can be in the same box, and they need three spaces each. That easy, right? All right, and then we have all you. Let's go ahead and box up you fools. Come on, attach. Attach, you son of a bitch. Damn it. There you go. There's your three spaces each. We can put these... No. Join those ones in a box. Now remember, they have to be rectangular. That's important. So we can go like... Whoop. We can put these guys in their own box, and we can put these guys in their own box. There's no real reason given why they can't have, you know, different than four sides, but that's how it is, damn it, and that's the way it's gonna be. It's all nice and pretty, too. Bam! I'm great at these. These are one of my favorite puzzles in the game.
Oh, look at that! He did it!
Yes. Oh, yeah, you betcha.
Answer my questions.
Sure. Fire them at me.
Fire!
You two are employed at the factory. Would you say it's a safe place to work?
As safe as any other place, I guess.
Yeah, except the new wing is haunted.
No, it isn't. You better quit listening to those hippies.
Why do you think the new wing is haunted?
When the factory expanded, we built a new wing. A bunch of locals got angry. We had to clear out part of the forest to do it.
Because spirits live in the forest.
Spirits?
You mentioned something about spirits in the forest. Really?
Depends on who you ask.
You won't see me out in the woods after sundown.
Well, me neither. But there ain't no spirits.
Do you guys know what happened to the foreman?
Yeah, the lobster bit him.
Shut up, Daryl.
What do you mean a lobster bit him?
He means Mike Lobb. Mike and Isaac didn't get along all the time. Had a little bit of a fight.
That's because Isaac thought he was smarter than all of us floor guys.
Well, he probably is.
No, he ain't. Just because he's a college boy don't make him smart.
All right. What about the repairman?
What do you know about the guy fixing the sign outside?
Randall Scruffman. Weird guy. He thinks the trees talk to him.
Yeah, but he sure picked the right line of work. He's gonna be employed forever. Stuff always needs fixing.
I think he looks extra hard for stuff to fix around here.
Yeah, so he can be close to Glory. She's the waitress here. Sweeter than moose milk in the morning.
How sweet is that?
Thanks, gentlemen.
Anytime.
You're good people. All right, let's talk to Bog again.
Sheriff. Agent Tethers, good. You're here.
Yep.
Listen, I wanted to ask you...
No time. I got a hunch about the factory. I got security camera records here of people leaving the factory.
Good. It'd be helpful to talk with whoever left last.
Exactly what I was thinking. I mixed up the photos so we can put them back in the right order.
What? Why would you do that?
You know how it is.
No, I don't. That's evidence.
The fuck is wrong with you? Rearrange Sheriff Boggs' photos to show the order in which the factory workers left. I do love that exchange there. What do you mean that's how it is? Alrighty. So, we can determine that number two left last, mostly because the car is only in the frame, you know, for all those pictures. Also, it looks like this guy's heading to the car. So there you go. We have this guy, there's no footsteps out there yet, so this guy leaves, then this guy leaves in the same direction, this guy goes to the car, and this guy leaves in the same direction as the last of the first two. This is apparently Mike Lobb, maybe, who knows. Just waiting for one of these to go reject, and I'll be all like, what the fuck? After I'm like so smug in my solving of them.
Yeah, yeah. That seems about right. Looks like the last one out was Mike Lobb.
You think he might have had something to do with the accident?
Nah.
Probably. Why don't you head out to the ice fishing huts on Lake Spence?
Okay.
He's not working, he's usually there trying to dead stick a lunker.
Got it. No. Wait, do what to a what?
Catch some fish. He's got himself a bright orange vest. Can't miss him. Anyway, to get there, you can take the snowmobile out to Sesame Woods. But you'll have to hoof it from there.
All right.
What do you know about Glory Davner?
Foreman's wife. Poor girl, she's a sweet kid. Her family has lived in this town for generations.
Maybe she has something to do with the accident.
That's ridiculous.
It could be an insurance.
Now you just leave poor Glory alone. She's having a hard enough time without you getting all accusatory.
All right.
What was the name of the factory worker I'm looking for?
The last guy to leave the factory was Mike Lobb. Drive out to Sesame Woods, then walk the trail out to the ice fishing huts.
Mm-hmm. All right, tell me about Sesame.
Is there anything I should know about the Sesame Woods?
Well, they've got the odd Wolverine in them.
What?
But they're probably hibernating or migrating or the like.
They're probably doing some kind of biodegrading over there or something.
I better get back to it.
You betcha.
All right, I think that's all the stuff we can do here for now anyway. We'll be back. Well, looks like he fixed it. Fuse worked. The fuck is that? Gotta love the reaction. Goes right for the gun. That's how you know he's American.
Tricks on my eyes. For a second, I thought I saw... It doesn't matter. I'm on my way to question Mike Lobb at the ice fishing huts. But to get there, I have to go through Sesame Woods. That doesn't sound dangerous at all.
Love that scream, by the way. Big fan. Anything else out here? Oh, there's a gun. Gotta get the gun. Even though I'm not gonna use it. Gotta get it. Alright, I don't think there's anything new at Vault is in yet. Let's go with Sesame Woods. Well, somebody's out there. Let's go ahead and take this gum. And this gum. What's this? Never mind the corpse.
Isaac Davner's ID badge. Looks like he came this way sometime before the accident. Why was Lobster, Mike Lobb, out here as well?
Alright, let's see what your puzzle is. Presumably. Pretty sure he's dead.
I think I found Mike Lobb. Late 30s. Looks like he froze to death, trying to solve some sort of problem. I'm gonna have a look.
Looks like he's clutching his feet together. Does anyone else see that? Was Mike Lobb following Isaac? Rotate the tiles to chart a path from Mike Lobb to the fishing hut. But beware, lest the path intersect with one upon which a shadowy figure lurks. Alright, so this one is fairly easy. We just need to make a route, and it can't fork or lead to any of these little bastards here. It's important, okay? It's not that hard. You just need to be careful. Let's see, I think it went like that. We can cheat a little like that, which I do enjoy. Like that, mm-hmm. Yeah. That would work, I think. Except for that, it leads to one of the bastards there, so we can't go that way. Let's try this way. Turn them around. Mm-hmm. No, can't do that. I seem to remember it going over it, but maybe I... not. It's gotta be that way. It's gotta be that way. Alright, so maybe like that. But how are we gonna fix you then? Hmm. I guess we could do it like that. That would work. Yeah. Yeah. That's using the old noodle. Uh-huh. Like that. And then like one of those. Right? So now there's no part that's leading to a shadowy figure. That one doesn't count. It has to have a line that actually goes to it. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure that'll work. Pretty sure. Let's see if I'm wrong. Ha-ha! Just gotta be observant.
Aha! No puzzle's gonna stop me in my tracks.
You solved the dead man's puzzle.
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean...
they tried to take him. Lock must not...
The lock on the factory door.
Key...
They freeze us back into the last position he was in.
What is this thing? I think I found something important in the hands of a dead lobster. I'm going to hold on to it for later.
Are we sure he's dead this time?
The lake with the ice fishing huts is just past the clearing. I'm going to continue on to see if anyone there seems to have this affliction.
Alright, anything else on this? We already looked at the ground, that was the Danvers ID badge. Let's go ahead and head out to the lake. Oh, it's our old friend. See what we got out here. We have a bucket of fish with bites taken out of them.
Found some freshly caught fish out on the lake. Looks like something has started eating them before they've been cooked.
Hmm. Could it be the raccoons that Ma thinks they are, or Martha? Let's take all this stuff here. All right, let's talk to the repairman.
Mr. Scruff. No, sir.
You look like a lost puppy. Go home, puppy.
I can't leave until I get that factory back open. I have a few more questions for you.
Of course you do.
All right, well, tell me about this fishing hut.
Is this your hut? It's nice.
Nope.
Oh. Well, what are you doing then?
Fixing stuff. That's my job. Lots of stuff getting broke lately.
Things get broken on these huts a lot?
Everything gets broken a lot. It keeps me busy.
Hmm.
Don't get any ideas. I just do my job.
Makes me wonder if Scruffman and Scruffy from Futurama, if either one of them are the inspiration for, you know, the other.
I understand. understand you have a thing for Mrs. Davner.
No, sir. Just think she's pretty. I expect you do as well.
Where were you on the night of the accident?
Busy. You accusing me of something?
I'm just asking. It's part of my job to be thorough.
I was working at the hotel.
Okay, see? That was easy.
We'll have to double check that story.
Where were you on the night of the accident again?
Working at the hotel.
Just to make sure.
You had to go through the woods to get here. Didn't you see a guy freezing on a tree stump?
Yep.
Why didn't you help him?
He didn't ask. Best not to interfere with acts of nature.
So you just let a guy die out there?
Had nothing to do with it. The cold will creep right up on you.
All right. See ya.
Thanks for your help. Goodbye. Mr. Scruffman claims he was working the night of the accident. I'm headed over to the hotel to check out his story now.
Anything else? No puzzle ruse? Not a one. All right, let's get out of here. Don't think anything's changed here, no. Let's see if this guy will react. Nope, you'll just go, ugh. Okay. You know, you could try to get him to the hospital. Clearly, he wasn't quite dead. Anyway, let's head back to Valda's Inn. Where this guy, we can talk to him again. Let's see if he says anything different.
Yeah.
Do you know Randall Scruffman?
I do. He's a good man. Good stock.
Despite his stock, you think he could have had anything to do with the accident at the factory?
Why don't you just let things run their course? Accidents happen, Mr. Tethers.
So, Randall Scruffman.
He's a valuable member of this community, and that'll be enough of you trying to say otherwise.
Do you think Glory Dabner's capable of violence? So that's a no.
All right, well, that was enlightening.
What was that?
Holy shit!
Heard a crash and a scream coming from inside the inn. Going inside to see what happened.
There'd be a doing to transpiring.
Don't need backup.
Because you're not getting it.
I heard a scream. Is everything okay in here?
The pipe on the fireplace. I turned my back on it for 1 second and boom.
Okay, don't panic. I'm sure we can find a way to fix it.
Oh yeah, you betcha. Rotate the tiles to reconstruct the wood stove's flue before the lobby fills with smoke. There's no time limit, don't worry. The stovepipe may be split, or may split, but sections must rejoin on the way of the chimney. You can't have any open circuits, essentially. Alright, let's see. What the?
Was that?
Hurry, it's getting away.
Saw a thing. It stole some pipe. Going after it. Checking out.
Oh my, but what about my furnace? You're all done?
Yes, ma'am. I'll be calling in the FBI's gnome squad. Or the National Guard, or the... someone better equipped to handle your situation.
Oh, I see. Guess I'll be needing to call the sheriff then and let him know.
Excuse me?
Yeah, the sheriff told me to give him a buzz the moment you left town.
Why would the sheriff assume I was leaving so soon?
Oh, I couldn't say. Will that be on a credit card, or should I just send the bill to Uncle Sam?
What is Sheriff Bog hiding? And that lock, it's on the outside of the door. On second thought, I better stick around, see this through.
Oh, great. Hot dish all around.
I think the sheriff wants me out of town. And what is the deal with that gear I found on Mike Lobb?
And airplane food. Bo's just out there.
I need to see a man about a furnace pipe.
Alright, let's go talk to Bo. It's alright, fella. No one's gonna eat you.
What was that thing? What happened? Did it try to eat your ear?
If two rows are white, rotations affect orientation, and
huh? Since Bo's brain got scrambled, all inputs end up in the pit of perplexity. I can't read that. Drag and drop arrows into all empty slots to redirect the stream of thought into the light of lucidity. Drag the arrows from the menu on each of the highlighted spaces. Your mission is to direct Bo's thoughts from Nelson up to the light bulb. Stream of thought will move in the direction of any arrow it hits. A brain tube will cause the stream of thought to bounce off in a right angle. When you think you have it all arranged, of course, submit like any other puzzle. Alright. So here's where it starts. It's going to immediately hit here and then progress upwards. We need it, of course, to get to the light bulb. So if it goes up here, where would we want to go? If we send it through here, we don't want to go left, obviously, because then it would just go into the pit of perplexity. So we'll have it go over here. It'll go bink, 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 bink. It'll end up here. So if we send it, we don't want to send it right, obviously, because if we did, then they go here, 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 back into the pits. So if we send it left, it'll go here, and then we have another chance to change its direction. I think we just want to have it go like here. Remember, we need to have stuff in all the spaces, so this is important. All right, and if it goes down here, perhaps we can direct it this way. No, that's still not going to work, is it? Alright. Let's see. This one's not terribly hard. Ding, ding, ding. Ding, 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 ding. Ding, ding, ding. Ding, ding, ding. Aha! Here we go. So if we put a left arrow here, it should go ding, ding, ding. So let's follow it all the way from the beginning to make sure. Ding, ding. Ding, 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 ding. Right? Right.
Hello?
Can even see it in action before it's submitted to the Department of Verification. There you go. Right to the light bulb. Stab the guy with the screwdriver and it becomes Manhunt. Don't want to stab him. We need the answers in the pipe. That would just ruin the investigation.
Well, that was a very interesting puzzle, but...
The whispers of the moon crashed too loudly.
The whispers what?
Clear the path.
Another piece.
Another gear.
Anything else out here?
I'd better not.
Yeah, let's not talk to him anymore. He's good. All right, now we have the piece of the stovepipe back. We can try this again.
What happened?
I got your pipe back. Let's finish putting this back together.
Yeah. We'll just jump right back into it. It works the same thing. If you forget, we need to make the thing of pipes go up to the top, and they need to be a closed circuit. It's important. Let's see. Doesn't matter if they split, they just need to be contiguous. I believe that's correct. Haha. Do. No. Perhaps some... No, that goes up there, too. don't like the way that looks. It doesn't look like it connects correctly. It also doesn't connect correctly. Let's try to work it backwards. Okay, that looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. But okay, maybe I need to curve it here. But I can't. This isn't really a good piece of pipe anyway, is it? This one's a bit confuzzling. I don't remember it being too hard when I first did this game. I remember there was at least one split when I did it the first time, so I'm not too upset with that. That's why I'm kind of not so sure about this. I think what I did is I like looked at the pipes and I said, that looks right. So far it doesn't look quite right. That looks better. Yeah. Yeah. Almost. Oh, it doesn't look right. Those do fit together well, though. That looks right. Is that a closed circuit? Kind of looks like it. I wonder if this is random, because this doesn't look like the one I used last time. It does look like it's a closed circuit all the way around, though. It's out of a stovepipe. Yeah, I think I'll go with that. Give it another look at, just because
I would like it to actually be right all the time. We can see the extra puzzle room.
Damn straight.
There you go. Your stove's all fixed.
Why, thank you, Mr. Tethers. You FBI types sure are handy.
Thank
Indeed.
You. Can I ask you something?
Of course.
You seem relatively coherent. Do people ever talk about seeing, little people in pointy hats?
The hidden people? Yeah, it's an old Nordic superstition. My grandfather used to tell me stories. They say they live among us in the ground, trees, rocks. But I just know the ones that live in my window.
Was Mr. Scruffman working here on the night of the accident?
Yeah, the fence outside was a terrible mess. I think some kids were trying to rip it down or something.
Did it take him long to fix?
Oh, yeah, all night. If you're still looking for suspects, I'd start looking at that Bjorn fella. But you didn't hear that from me.
Okay. Ha-ha! She's all, like, smiley and everything after that.
Also, the number of kids that you'll see in this game is a number, well, less than one.
Tell me anything more about the hidden people?
Oh yeah, tourists love the stories, but Bjorn and his friends take them very seriously.
Oh?
Oh yeah, they don't like the decorative gnomes in my window.
Maybe they took the missing one. Or perhaps the missing one did just run away. Is there anything else in here? There's more gum. And Ald is right. He welded the pipes together somehow, too. How do you do that? Maybe you just use some fittings, right? Who knows?
Well, Mr. Scruffman's alibi checks out. Mike Lobb is dead. And I just saw living garden gnomes. I think I'm gonna head back to the diner and have a chat with Sheriff Bob.
Okay. Game does a good job of keeping you on track. Oh, good.
Help wanted.
A completely unrelated puzzle-roo. The varsity muskrats got after-school jobs at Hank's window shop, but they can't skip football practice. Help them complete a pass without breaking any glass. Alright, so on this one, we just need to connect a line between all the players. One contiguous line. Alright, so let's see. Pretty sure you can connect a line there. I think you need to be the star of the end of one of these, so you can go there. Maybe here, then here, then here, then here, then here, then there. No, damn it! Ah, you ruined everything. Look what you did. There you go. So, you can see the line does not intersect with the glass. You go ding, 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 ding. Perfect. And, of course, Bjorn is gone. The one that Martha suspects. Oh, well. All we know is that we know that the Varsity Muskrats are doing a good job. And they're going to do good at the game.
Well, that takes care of that one.
Okay, no extra puzzles there. There will be one later, actually. Ring, ding, ding, ding. All right, let's head back to the Moose Ear Diner. Told you we'd be back. Huh, Glory's gone. There's puzzlers everywhere, some gum.
Those chairs weren't here before, were they?
Nope. One of them Nordic guys brought them in right after I ordered my pie. Pie that I'm still waiting for.
Hmm. Something odd about them.
Hmm. Something spray paint on this stack of Escher chairs. Arrange them to discover the hidden image. Alright. I do like this one. This one's pretty fun. So let's just go ahead and throw all these chairs out here. This is kind of a jigsaw puzzle, but it's a little different from the ones we've seen before. Hmm. No, not quite. Ah, perfect. That one goes there. I believe this goes here, or not. Something like that, perhaps? Oh, good. That one actually flipped into the spot I wanted. Not quite. Still not quite. That looks right. No. That one goes there, though. Okay. Uh-huh. Hmm. That one looks perfect. Don't change a thing. We have an angry moon spouting, apparently, vines. Moon banana. There you go. Easy peasy.
That image you just made? That's the symbol those lodge guys use.
Weird.
Interesting. What do you guys know about Bjorn?
You mean the old hippie who spies on people out by the hotel?
He's one of those old Nordic guys that hangs out at the lodge. Brothers of Skoggins or something like that.
Brothers and weirdos, if you ask me.
Lodge, huh? I'll check it out.
Okay. Well, let's see if you have anything
How
new.
How you doing, Steve?
You got any new business?
How's business?
Who wants to know?
I'm just making conversation.
Oh. Well, maybe you can help me figure something out then. It's been driving me crazy.
Once again, Loner Steve needs your help to attach the bags to the birds. Don't forget the rules. They're the exact same as last time. You need here are the values. Birds are shown carrying the max weight. And they can team up. And they need to be balanced. Also, don't cross the lines. Now, this one is one of the ones I got wrong the first time, but I thought I had the right answer. Which is funny, because I redid the same thing, and it worked. So I was very confused. Also, I'll give you a hint to the answer on this one. We'll count the gnomes. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 6. We have 15 gnomes. For the birds, we have, of course, these ones carry 2. This one carries 4. This one carries 3. So we have 2, 4, 8, 12, 10, 13. Oh, wait. My brain apparently didn't work. Well, let's count that in a different way. We have 6. We have 14. There we go. 17. So we have 2 extra two extra gnomes that we don't need to carry, which will give you a hint. One of these birds you don't actually have to use. It's this guy right here. So we can go like this. We can go like this. Maybe what happened is he actually accidentally got attached to his feet. That's probably what it was. So something like this should be the solution. So 1-1 to him. 1-1 to him. 2-2, yeah. 2-2, and then 3. This guy's not carrying anything. So that should be the answer. Let's see if it is. Like I said, I thought I did this the first time I played this game, and it told me it was wrong, and I redid it, and it accepted it. It's weird. Hot Hawks. Kind of like those ones, too. They're pretty fun.
How are you doing?
You had something else. Hidden people.
Do you know anything about hidden people?
Collectors will pay a tidy sum for a wooden one.
But you don't believe in them, do you?
Do I seem crazy to you?
Nah.
See you, Steve.
Just shady. What are you guys doing?
Hello again, Daryl. And Daryl. I don't see the waitress around. Did she go somewhere?
That's a good question. I ordered some key lime about 20 minutes ago.
20 minutes?
Okay, this might sound silly, but have you guys ever heard about hidden people?
My cousin's neighbor saw one once.
Oh, not this again.
He swears they're real.
So do those Nordic tree huggers, but that doesn't make it so.
So the hidden people are just a bunch of make-believe then?
Yep.
Not according to my cousin's neighbor.
Well, we almost did shoot one, didn't we, Tethers?
You two have any more bugs you need boxed?
Actually, yeah. That sounds like fun. Let's box up some more bugs.
Okay.
Seriously? I was joking.
Let's get to it.
No backing out now. Daryl's bugs are loose again. Connect the points to the to box them back up. Keep these rules in mind. The rules are the same as last time. We need to enclose all bugs using the fewest number of lines. They need to be four-sided. Bugs of the same type, of course, can share a box. The green ones can need 3 spaces of territory, and the pink ones need 2 each. Alright, so we can put you guys in a box here. Nah, that's not good. Reset it. We can do it like this. Yeah. Don't like the way that looks either. Okay, let's try it this way. I have a natural feeling about these thanks to my spatial awareness. So maybe like this? As for you... You could be like this. Except that doesn't look good. Doesn't look good. Needs to look good. It's important. So maybe something like that for you. Whoa. Hey. Nah, something's not right about that. Something ain't right about him. Damn it, game. Stop playing with my emotions. Okay, like that. Then like that. Because I could go like that, and I could go like this, but I... Damn it, game. Stop it. No. Nothing about this makes sense at all. I have a natural feeling for what the solution is, and that ain't it. Maybe something like that, something like this. Then you guys could be over here. This will be your bug spot.
I said bug spot, damn it. Bug spot. Spot of bugs. There you go. Fuck you.
You guys can have this area. You can have this area. There we go. Now it looks right. So let's make sure. 2, 4, 3, 6, 1, 3, 1, 3, 2, 6. Looking good. Bam, potato salad.
Okay.
Another puzzle solved.
Eat it, puzzles. But wait, there's more.
Hello again, Daryl. And Daryl.
More box?
Let's try to box those bugs again.
Let's get to it.
Once again, Daryl's bugs have busted loose. Connect the points to box them back up and keep the rules in mind again. They're the same. Well, every time I did this, I like scrutinize the rules. I'm all, did they add something new? No. It's the same. I do like these, though, as I've indicated before. Alright, so this goes here, I'm fairly sure. Look at these guys. Look, I said look at these guys. They belong together. Damn you, game. Stop playing with the emotions. So you could be there. You could be here. No. Tight rot. Maybe something like this? Nah. Doesn't look like it's gonna be right either. Nah. Well, we could try boxing you all up like this, but then we'd have this gaping, awkward space over here. We just can't have that. Nah. So maybe I was right initially. Maybe this is how it's supposed to be. Also, I find the sound that this makes whenever I connect the boxes extremely satisfying, and I can't really say why. Oh, shit. This would make more sense if you knew the rules, said Zeffy. Okay, well, here's the rules. In case all the bugs with the fewest number of lines possible. The box that you enclose them in has to be four-sided. It needs to be a square or it needs to be a rectangle. The bugs of the same type can share a box, like these two guys. The green ones need three spaces of territory, as indicated here, and the pink ones need two each. So like this guy, there's a total of six boxes, and there's two green guys in there. That's enough territory. Same thing with this. We have two pink ones, and they have four. Okay, I think... Let me try something here. Just going out on some kind of crazy limb. Like this? No, that'd still be extremely weird. Because there's... I remember being this the first time, too, and there's never a case where there's something like this. So let's reset. Also, you may think about doing something like this. I don't think this is going to be enough space for all the little rascals. We have 12 boxes and 5 of these guys. They need to have a total of 15. So that wouldn't be enough for them. Nah, it's much simpler than that. Usually it's boxes of like 6. Like so. Maybe that's the answer. Can you connect the lines? Thank you. Appreciate it. Sorry to be mad. Like that, maybe? It's still too awkward. Want to go like that, and then go like this, but it just doesn't look right. Like that wouldn't... It wouldn't be rectangular right there, so you can't have that. This is the first one that's really challenged me, hasn't it? Maybe if I go like this. Yeah. Then like this. Then you guys... Wait, haven't we been through this? We have been through this before. I remember making this exact line. So maybe if I box up these ones. No, I've done this before too. All right, which combination am I not looking at? No. It's all wrong. Zeffy says, try again starting with the pink bugs in the middle. These guys? All right. There's two ways they can really be connected up. We could always do it like this, but we'd have a huge amount of space. So I figure it's got to be like this, or it's got to be like... like that. If it's like that, that wouldn't really look good. Of course, we could always... Could always do something stupid like this. I think this may be the answer. We still have that awkward spot up there, though. Ah, was that it? I think that might be it. I remember making... I was thinking back to my memories. And I was thinking, you know what? I remember these things being a lot... like the individual bugs being wrapped up a bit like this. Yeah, this may be the answer. This certainly is a answer. Is it the right answer? Looks fairly efficient. Let's give it a shot. Come on, no whammies. Okay, we're good. Super bugs in boxes.
Done. That wasn't so bad.
Yeah, it wasn't too bad. It was a nice little challenge. Any more bugs? No more bugs. Alright, let's get to the sheriff, finally. So, that repairman, his alibi checks out.
I checked up on the repairman. He was working at the hotel on the night of the accident.
Alibi checked out, huh?
He's in the clear. He couldn't have been involved.
Alright, though, what about Bjorn?
Have you looked into Bjorn and his friends? He seems to be an avid environmentalist. Perhaps the accident is a political statement.
Nah, Bjorn's always been a major part of this community. Since even before my badge was pinning up my diapers.
You wore a sheriff's badge on your diapers?
This is a community that celebrates its Nordic heritage, Agent Tethers. One that advocates violence.
Mm-hmm. Well, what about hidden people?
Have you heard about this hidden people superstition?
It's not a superstition, Tethers.
You had me going there, Tethers. A government agent investigating elves and hippie legends.
Yeah, how'd you going there?
One of those rude little bastards stole the pipe. Remember that? And one was hiding behind the snowmobile. You saw it whispering into Bo's ear. I don't think it's a superstition so much.
Wrap it up for today and start fresh tomorrow.
But you haven't really done anything. And we're no closer to getting that factory up and running.
Agent Tethers, I'm not from the big city. Around here, we take our time. Keep our heads clear.
As far as I can tell, everyone's heads are filled with puzzles.
Puzzles are a way to keep yourself from asking questions you don't want answers to.
What does that mean?
It means... I'll see you in the morning, Agent Tether.
All right. Well, we're done here.
starting to look more and more suspicious. I just got a tip that he holds secret meetings in a local lodge. I remember seeing something about a lodge on my Scoggins map. I wonder if it's the same one.
Let's go check it out. Anything out here before? Oh, yep. I clicked right on that when I was doing the echo. Or my little sonar routine. There's the lodge. Let's buzz on over there. It seems to be covered with a contraption. What is this?
There's some bright orange cloth caught on this sign. I wonder if Mike Love was trying to get away from this place in a hurry.
Possible. Let's get that. And any other? No. Well, there's clearly a puzzle room.
See what's going on inside. Well, they probably shouldn't have made this a puzzle then.
Yeah, you tell them. Draw a straight line from one red dot to another that will slice through every barrier blocking the window. For some reason, we only get one cut here, and it needs to go through all the change and all the boards. The boards are the easiest ones to look at, so we'll look at those first. All right, so like this one here, it cuts through the gray chain, the black chain. It's the silver chain, but really doesn't hit that chain, so let's try this instead. Alright. No, but that doesn't hit that. It needs to hit that board. It's important. Alright, what about like this? It's that board, that board, that board, and that board. Excellent. But it doesn't hit that chain. Damn it. What about like this? Did I try this before? I think I did. Yes, it doesn't hit the gray one. Ho-hum. Maybe like this. Alright, it's hitting not all the boards. It needs to hit all the boards. Okay, now it'll hit all the boards. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hits all four boards. Hits the black chain, the white chain, the light gray chain, and the dark gray chain. So that one looks like it actually would get them all. Board, 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 board. Mm-hmm. Chain, 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 chain. See you later there, Zeffy. There we go. Easy peasy. Hey, Glory's in there. And Bjorn.
If you want a good look around, you might try knocking on the door.
Sheriff Bob! Oh, you startled me.
Snooping doesn't suit you, Agent Tethers. What are you doing here?
Oh, you know, the lodge.
What the heck is going on in there?
They meet regularly and celebrate their cultural traditions. But that's their business, not yours.
There's something about this crew that seems off to me.
Agent Tethers, you're here to get the factory back open. Not to question or belittle the beliefs of the townsfolk.
I'm pretty sure I saw Glory Dabner in there.
The waitress? I doubt it.
She was standing right there a second ago.
Time to go, Agent Tether. I'll escort you back to the hotel. Make it an early night. Turn in, Agent Tether. I don't want to see you out here again tonight. Trust me, you don't want to be out here either.
Well, he's being rather antagonistic, isn't he?
Sheriff Bog definitely isn't working with me. I'm sure I saw Glory Dabner at the lodge. And now Glory Dabner's sneaking around town. going to follow him.
Okay. Let's see, have any new puzzles emerged? They have!
I wonder what happened.
Well, let's see. The Varsity Muskrats are still working hard at Hank's window shop. Help them complete a pass without breaking the glass. So, same deal. We need to make a contiguous line between each of these folks. This one's probably going to be the hardest one to get to. He's only got two people we can pass to. Well, really not that hard then. Maybe you? You could pass over there. Yeah, you're one of the ends, so you have to pass here. You could pass... really just a... not him. You could pass the him, and that's really all. You couldn't pass down there or there, I'm fairly sure. Whoops. Yeah, see, it would break the glass. Same thing with that one. Can't have that. Can't be breaking the glass. From here, you can not really pass that way or that way. So here? No, last time I did this so damn quick. No, you'd break it. Uh-huh. No. Maybe instead of that... Whoa. Careful now. No. That won't work, damn it. Aha! No. Okay. Who can you pass to? You can only really pass to him. So we know where the ends are. They gotta be here. Aha! There's a sneaky way you can go there. Who the hell can you pass to then? You can't pass the him. You can't pass the him. No, not quite. Whoops. Alright, so maybe we can break the chain here and get to these other folks. No. No. Here we go. Whoops. Actually, that would work. It's hard to tell if that's a contiguous line or not. So we start down here, go around. No. Huh. Does that look different from last time? I can't even tell. But that's definitely a contiguous line. It goes here. And as far as I can tell, it doesn't break the glass, so... Summit! Steel Shadow says, I bet the sheriff did it. Damn straight accepted. There may be multiple solutions to that one, I don't know.
Well, that was interesting, but I figured it out.
Yeah, it wasn't too bad. But we're too good at puzzles. Anything new in here? Oh, there's some more gum. I don't think there's anything new outside. So, we were going to go ahead and follow Glory. See, Nelson's got snowmobile trouble again. Rearrange the logs so he will track all those footprints before arriving at Glory's destination. So, this is similar to the first one we did, the first puzzle ever. Well, not really the first puzzle ever, the first puzzle we ever did in Scoggins. Of course, these have to be arranged on the grid.
The snowmobile will start off heading south. Hits a log, it'll bank right or left depending on that log's orientation. Nelson must hit every footprint, instead of every stoplight, on the way to the mystery spot.
Alright, so there's the mystery spot, and here are all the footprints. So we need to have him cross all of them. So he could go, like, down here. Bum, bum, bum. Let's see. The thing about this is, if you're astute, there's only one way we can get in there. We can't pass through the trees, by the way. So the only way he can really be bounced in is not from here, or here. He needs to go in from this angle. So how are you going to do that is the question. Well, let's see. Let's go ahead and bounce him this way. Take him around there. Bounce him that way, that way, that way. Okay, so ding, 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 ding. That would send him into the into the blue yonder there, so let's not do that. That would get him to hit all of them, but it's not the solution, and that's what matters. Oh, or we could just move that up and fix everything, right? So, ding, 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 ding. Just to verify it does hit the prints. Yes. Ding, 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 ding. Ding, 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 all footprints, and we arrive at the mystery spot. The spot of mystery! So far, we're still suffering a flawless victory, which is good.
Glory was headed toward the factory. I gotta catch up with her.
I want to see that extra puzzle I've never seen before. What could it mean? Oh shit, they know! It's a pretty thick trees behind. Or he's a very lanky man. And we died. Game over. Excuse me, floating man, there's gum that I must obtain. So, where are you? Where are we? Who are you? How'd you get such awesome chops? Anyway, what's with these gnomes? Why are you clutching one of the hats so, I don't know, lovingly, aggressively? Who knows?
What are those things? The gnomes? Was that real? Yes? What is it?
Hmm.
direct the pass to reconnect the loose ends. Red to red, yellow to yellow. But be careful not to let the wires cross. A path segment can run between any two adjoining points. Alright, so we have a yellow wire here, and two red ones. Now, I remember this being... You got to use every hole on this breadboard, which is kind of weird. Also, any of these lines, they don't matter at all. You don't have to worry about those lines. Alright, so the easy one would be the yellow, the yellow. And you also can't cross his face because, you know, reasons, I guess. So if I remember correctly, it goes a little something like this. Easy peasy, am I right? You just have to take the red wire across the world. It's not like you have to do anything too hard. Yellow, yellow, red, red, good, 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 good. Thought the game crashed there for a second. Now that was just Tethers crashing. We find ourselves in the lodge, apparently.
What happened?
I found you unconscious in the woods. Did they speak to you?
Did who speak to me? I'm looking at a photograph of the Brotherhood. Isaac and Mike Lobb seem to be part of this group, and they seem to be friends. Interesting.
Awesome hair on Mike there. Okay. Well, what's that on the table? I want to look at the table. I can't look at the table.
I'm gonna need some real answers now.
Alright, what the hell's going on here?
What exactly is going on here? What's wrong with these people?
They are in deep meditation. If you open your mind and let yourself hear the whispers, there will be no mysteries in life you cannot solve. Speak to them yourself if you want solutions.
Also, a thing says this is going to turn to a space-themed Zero Escape game now, referring to the last portion. I actually would like to try that Zero Escape game, I think, is the one Plump is playing, and it's sort of interesting. It's like Escape the Room, the game. It's just like, it's pretty neat. I would like to try it. Tell me about the gnomes, man.
What are these little creatures I keep seeing?
They are not creatures. They are people older than any of us, living in what nature still exists around us.
All dragon whispers, kill them.
Isaac Dabner's still alive, isn't he? The lock on the factory door. He didn't build it himself. You put it there to keep him in. Or to keep people out. Why?
He has been spoken to. It is actually a great honor to have been chosen.
Chosen for what?
That is not for us to ask.
I'm gonna need a second to question these people.
Do what you must.
Okay. Is Amma just do this whole thing too?
I don't think so, Agent Tethers.
I want those, though. This is right there. You're not really in that deep of meditation. I'm going to tell the hidden people you're cheating. Anyway.
Rocks, trees, animals. Do you ever just stop and watch the birds, Mr. Tethers? A quorum of crows congregating in rows.
Oh, yes, this puzzle. This one is a bit of an ass. Bjorn has photos that show a quorum of crows on his clothesline. A dark omen, to be certain. Keeping in mind the images may overlap, what's the minimum number of crows pictured? Alright. So, in this one, you need to mentally or just... what am I thinking here? You need to overlay these things in a way that makes sense and has the fewest number of crows. Now let me see if I have... I do have my notes here for this, which is good. Let's see. So the way I did
is I represent each of the birds with a number. I made the crows zeros, I'm fairly certain. And I made the bluebirds two, and I made the redbirds ones. And it made it much easier for me to overlay what these things were. So, like, for instance, we have this picture down here. That'd be 211, or 2110. Then we'd have, like, 0100. Let's see. We could overlay it with that, but that would not be the best. We should probably put the bluebirds on the end. That's how I have it arranged, actually. So we have that one. That one. Trying to figure out which one I had next. Probably this guy, because it'd overlap on that one perfectly. You just have another one after that. Then I have the alternating ones. Okay. So, the sequence you would get in the end would be 211010010002, which would mean you'd have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Pretty sure that's it. 6 crows. Right? Good, good, good. I think so.
No. Yes. Maybe.
Yes. We'll go with 6. If I'm wrong, that's what I get. I'm pretty sure my notes are right here. I'm glad I kept this notepad around. Fish. All right. Well, it was bound to happen. I thought that fell a little high. I think it is 5, actually, is the right number. So let's think about this again. Told you that was going to happen. So now I get to go through the whole game again to get all these fucking things right again. That's good. Okay. Well, anyway, enough bitching. Let's do this right. So, 2110. Uh-huh. 1 Okay, so it'd be 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. That one would be negated. 3, 4, 5, 6. Damn it. That's what it says on there, huh? I'm almost certain it's 5, damn it. I'm going to go with my gut and say 5. We'll see if I'm right. We've already got it wrong, so it's all a bunch of horseshit anyway. Good! Fuck you. That's for ruining my perfect streak. And as you'll see, you lose 3 stars. If you use a hint, you only get 1 star taken off. Does it show us the actual... Okay. I was hoping it'd show us a nice picture of all the crows, but there you go.
That's a piece of the machine locking the factory.
Indeed. He's not going to tell you. Now let's talk to you.
You see them, don't you? Listen to their words. Their riddles.
Edvard knows it's time to stock the Vindovach River with gricklebacks. Drag the 4 clutches of fish to the release points, keeping in mind these rules. This one's pretty difficult, too. Schools of fish will swim toward the river, splitting evenly at each fork. A school that can't split evenly will be paralyzed with indecision, because of reasons. Marsh marmots will eat all fish who enter their turf. The marmots will either be at Mythpick Marsh or Abdominal Swamp.
But not in both places. Exactly 16 fish must arrive safely at the river. No more, no less. Alright, so here's our map. We need to arrange the fish onto these squares to make sure they reach the place. And remember, you couldn't put the three here because they die. You couldn't put the three here because they die, and you can't put them here because they die. So you must put them there. Alright. Let's go ahead and put that one down there. And let's see. Put that one there and this one here. Alright, so let's go through the scenarios that will happen. We'll put the mouse here to represent the marmots. So, let's start the four up here. They're going to split once. Two will go down here. Two will go up here. Assuming that the marmots are up here, two will make it to the swamp. As well as all of these, right? We'll have eight. We'll have eight, 11, and two. So there you go, 13. Now these ones will go here. Half of them will get eaten by the marmots. They'll make three. They'll make 16, right? Right. All right, but what if the marmots are down at Abdominal Swamp? Well, let's see. The three will go out, the four will go here, and they're going to get eaten. So that means only seven are getting out of this fork. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, we have these six. They all get out because nothing's here. And then two go down here and get eaten. So that means that eight get out, right? Right. So we have eight plus seven. That's not right. That's not enough fish. Maybe I need to put them in a different area. Or was my math wrong? That can happen. 2, 8, yeah. Yeah, so maybe like that. Let's try this scenario then. Okay, the marmots are up there. Half of these guys get eaten. Of course, that's going to be six. Or that's going to be four out. These ones are going to split the fork. Then they're going to split again. That means that only one's going to get out from there. So we have a total of five up here. Meanwhile, one's going to go down here. He's going to get out. And all these guys are going to go out. And that would be 16. Right? 5, 11. Yes. Well, 5. No. My math. I'm getting a little tired, I think. Let me use my notepad. That'll make this a bit easier. Alright, so we have four, they go out, half get eaten, so four make it, then this splits into two, and then into one. One makes it out. Alright, good. This one goes down here, he's five. Actually, two go down there, that was my problem. They split by two. So two make it out, then all these bastards make it out. That's nine. So that'd be 11, 12, 16. Perfect. All right, let's test the other scenario. The marmots are down here in an abdominal swamp. That means eight get out, no problem. Also two more, so that makes 10. These two that went down here, they're going to die. That's just how it is. All right, and then we're going to have three more die, because they're going to split this fork, and that means six get out. So 10 and 6, oh my god, that's 16 too. Perfect, we have it just the way it needs to be. Can't do my math in my head tonight. I'm too tired. Still pissed off at those dumb crows. I knew that was going to be a breaking point for me. Well, we have two of these bastards. Two of these bastards asleep, right? So I need to get the rest of the... Well, clearly he's not going to let us just take him. He's going to growl at us. Of course it is. The probability is you'll be able to solve Soxior's riddle. Alright.
Blind Lars Jorgen's mother knitted him 25 pairs of socks. 5 were striped, 5 plaid, 5 spotted, 5 argyle, and 5 with owls playing the fiddle. Being a teenager, Lars failed to pair his socks and threw them randomly in his drawer. How many socks must Lars pull out before he can absolutely be certain to be holding a matching pair? Well, that would be 6, would it not? Because, I mean, if he had 6, they'd have to have at least 1 double. It's pretty easy when you think about it, right? If he picked out 5, they could be like 1 of each. But if he pulls out a 6th, well, then it's going to be 1 of those. There you go. Easy peasy.
That's all of the pieces. Now I just need to reassemble them.
Oh boy. This gear appears to be one of those assemble-it-yourself dealies. Can you fit the pieces together? Maybe. Pretty bad at puzzle ruse, though. God damn it!
Damn it. Where are you, you little thief?
Alright, anything else? No, it doesn't look like it. Well, let's follow these tracks. Arrange the logs to help Nelson collect the stolen pieces of the broken gear and discover where the gnome is hiding. So we have another one of these. This is exactly the same rules. So let's go ahead and get started. We need to run over all the gears on our way to the factory, which is this. Okay, and we have some stack logs we can't move, which are these guys. We can put stuff here, which is nice. It's not really that hard, I don't think. I think that's the hardest part right there. We need to align a log to hit that piece. Then we can have it go down. I'm trying to remember exactly how I did this. Goes like that. Anyway. There's a spot in here for a reason. I remember that much. What am I forgetting here? I think we need to start this a bit earlier, actually. Oh yes, I can't move that log. That's right, I forgot. Is it something like that? I think it may be. Alright, so he goes here, he hits this, goes down there, goes right there, 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 there. Okay, that would not hit all of them. We're missing these ones over here. No, we get those. But we're missing a few others. I'm pretty sure we got to start this a bit higher. We may actually hit this one twice, too. Ding, ding, ding. Ding, ding. Aha. Ding, ding, ding. Ding, ding, ding. Ding, ding. Ding, ding. Ding, ding, ding. Aha. We could put one here, then put one here, and then Jesus would descend from the heavens, I'm pretty sure. Alright, let's make sure he can actually get to the mystery spot first. Ding, 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 ding. Okay, so he's going to make it there. Let's make sure he hits all the pieces. Alright, so he gets these two, then these two, then these two, those ones. Then he gets all of these,
Ding, 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 ding. He gets all of those. All of these are done. Ding, ding, ding. He's got those. Ding, ding. I'm pretty sure that's everything. It's hard to, like, just look at it and say, yes, he did hit everything, but I'm fairly sure he did. Now that I've, you know, failed that one puzzle, I'm feeling like, what's even the point? We went everywhere and got all the stuff. There was no stuff we did not get. Easy peasy.
Gotcha.
Sucker?
One of those things stole the last piece I need to get into the factory. Looks like it's headed toward the lake.
The lake, huh?
May try to protect it. I'm not sure. Either way, I'm getting that piece back.
Now, I'm pretty sure the next puzzle we're going to be walking up on is one of my least favorite in the game, because it is one of the most difficult. Sesame Woods. Not that it really matters now. You're still Uggin. That's good. Uggin and Thuggin. Oh, there it is. Doesn't look like a trap at all. Nope. Well, let's go in there.
Hey, let me out!
You don't understand! The hidden people need Isaac! I don't know why, but you have to let him go with them!
I'm not gonna let you people keep him locked up in a factory like bait.
I'm sorry.
Well, we're gonna die. The key to the skylight is inside one of these dead fish. But which? Hurry and find it. The ice fishing hut is sinking fast. I hate this one. It's a word puzzle, and it's kind of obtuse. Well, it's not really obtuse. It's just incredibly silly. Each fish has one other fish inside it, except for the one with the key. That's right. All these fish hanging from the line have another fish inside them. Counting the swallowed fish, the whiskered redfish is the least numerous kind here. All fishes dine on the next rung of the food chain, except for the tiny tanfish, who eat their own kind. The key is on the line with five fish. Well, clearly it would be. That means it's got to be over here, or it's got to be over here. Alright, let me remember the logic of this one. Can't remember if it was that fish, or if it was you, or what. Can't remember if there are five of each fish or not. Alright, let's think about this. Well, nothing can eat the redfish. The redfish is the largest. And that's just how it works in nature, right? Right. So, assuming that's true... Let's see, I had numbers for this, too, I think. Ah, yes, here it is. I think I determined it was in a green fish. Just based on the numbers we're seeing here. Because we know that, well, no, they... It's funny, because these fish only dine on the lowest ones on the food chain, or the next lowest. So, they'd be eating these blue guys. Which means there were six of them? Yes, there were six blue fish initially. Hmm.
trying to remember the logic of this one because it is just so... so dumb. Well, we know there's a total of... let's see. Eight fish? Well, we just go like eight. Six, so 14. And then we have... five. Because, of course, one's not going to have one. So 14 plus 5, 19. There's going to be 19 fishes in total. So remember that. There's 19 fishes. And I'm fairly sure it's this line again. So one of these guys has it. All the other ones have another fish inside them. Because of reasons. Alright. We know that the redfish is the least common fish here. There's only four of them. That's how much there was always going to be. So on that logic, shouldn't there always be an increasing number of fish? Because you guys have green fish in you, which would be five. You would eat the two other one. There'd still be five blue fish. Yous guys would have yellow fish in you. So one, two, three. Ah, yes, that's right. All right. So there's four kinds of fish. And assuming that, they gotta eat... means they all have one of the other fish inside them. Damn thing. Anyway, there's gonna be four and then five of the other ones. That's how it works. Clearly, there are four redfish. So, assuming you guys are all full, I think it actually is this red guy here. Pretty sure it's him. Let's see if the logic works out. Alright, so we have three U, five blue fish, we have five green fish, and we have one, two, three, four. We only have four of you, huh? Four tan fish. Would that really work out? Yep, that's right, Zonarak. 4, 5, 5, plus one for the key. Like, I'm fairly sure it's you, but I can't really explain why it's you, and that makes me feel bad. Let's just go ahead and submit it. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. If I'm right, the game will tell me why I'm right. Most certain that it's that guy. That's right. Lethal's right as always. Except for that one time. We don't talk about that time. Never happened. All right. So here's the logic behind it. The key is on the line with five fish. We had that clue. So it had to be on that one or it had to be on that one. Let's see. Must be on the line with three visible fish. Two of another kind inside them. Of course, the other one has the key. If the redfish is the least numerous, there must be five of every other species by that logic. Right? Right. If you did the math, you would deduce that there's one redfish without a bluefish inside it. Okay.
There's only one redfish on the line with three visible fish. Well, that is the math I did, so yes. We wins. Ah, did I just, like, look at it wrong? I can see that all. Either way, we found the key in the fish and we can escape, presumably.
That was a close call.
What the heck happened here, Agent Tethers?
Sheriff Bob, Glory Dabner tried to kill me.
Come on, Tethers. You sure that sweet little girl?
Did he even see her?
She is not as innocent as she looks.
Okay, I'll go find her and ask her if you...
Well, I guess he heard her.
You stay out of trouble now.
Sorry, I was destroyed by the fish. Still, we're making great progress. I think we're almost to the bottom of this, Tethers.
My office. It's warm in my office. It's quiet in my office. There are no maniacal gnomes or chainsaw-wielding waitresses in my office. I need to get back to the lodge, fix that gear, and get the hell out of here.
Let's see, I don't think there's anything here. We saw the fish. They're still half-eaten.
Found some freshly caught fish out on the lake. Looks like something is...
Yeah, something's been eating them. We've heard this. You can step away from the fish. There's Mike Lobb. We're still just gonna leave him there. Not even try to get to him to a hospital or, you know, call 911 or anything. Hell, we're not even gonna tell the sheriff about that guy. I didn't mean to go here. Anyway. We have the gear. We need to go back to the lodge. Okay, let's try this again.
Back together.
Appears to be one of those assemble-it-yourself dealies. Puzzle reminds me a lot of, can't remember if they're called tanagrams or tetragrams or whatever, but they're just like these shapes that I fit together in elementary school and whatnot. Uh-oh.
I can't let you go. You just don't come into our town and pretend you know how everything works.
I think I'm starting to figure it out.
Go get it. The people in this town can't resist puzzleroos. It's the language of the little people, the hidden people, whatever. Son of a bitch.
Sheriff's as crooked as they come. Looks like he sabotaged my snowmobile.
Of course. Sheriff Bug has sabotaged Nelson's snowmobile. Rotate the tiles to create a path from the fuel tank to the exhaust. Alright. So here's the exhaust. It's sort of hard to see. And I'm pretty sure that's the fuel tank. Fairly sure. So it needs to go like that. Pretty sure that's alright right there. All part of my elaborate scheme. Not quite. There you go. Looks perfect. Don't change a thing. This reminds me of watching Ald, who's currently in the chat, play through Xenosaga's slide puzzles. I think that was in Xenosaga Episode 2. It was a real shame he didn't have me around for that, because I whip slide puzzles. Oh, shit. All right, so we're making real progress here.
Isaac, I'm with the FBI, Department of Puzzle Research. If you're still in there, don't worry. I'm coming in to rescue you.
Nelson's three gears seem to come apart, and it looks like the pieces can be rearranged into one big giant gear. Can you get it into gear to solve the puzzle? Can you get into gear to solve the puzzle? Maybe. Maybe I can, Dick. Maybe I can. So let's go ahead and slide these guys here, where it matters. These are the biggest teeth, the most complete. So we shall put them where they belong. Now we need to figure out what goes into these slots. And I believe it's something like this. Yep, it likes it. Of course it does. You like that, don't you? I knew it. That's not what I wanted. I wanted this one. Aha. Perfect. Mm-hmm. That is not what I want, but... that one goes there. Just put that there. There we go. That one goes there. Sometimes it's easier just to put all these little teeth everywhere. Mm-hmm. 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 Okay, that's almost good. Perfect. Alright, we have one ring gear, but we need to do more. Let's see, how did this fit together? There's some kind of... maybe? No. There we go. They fit in there kind of weird. Not there. Aha! It's a very weird-looking gear. It looks good. It's all in one piece. Yep. Swinging around just to make sure it's nice and good. Hey there, Barte. Welcome back. No, we're on the home stretch there, Zeffy. It's not over yet. But I think you did miss me failing. I failed one puzzle so far. I got my second try.
That was a tricky one.
It's about fucking crows. Stupid crows. There we go. Contraption off. And the floor is covered with bear traps. Such 3D effects.
I'm coming to get you.
All right. There's some more gum. More gum there. Let's see, Nelson's path is blocked by a giant Scoggins eraser. Cut the support to drop the obstacle, but don't drop Nelson by mistake. Alright, so this one's not too bad. You just need to follow the line carefully. So you have this one wrapped around the eraser, you just go... Kind of goes up there. Whips around here. It's amazing it has the strength to stay up in the air when it's this... tangled up. Alright, looks like 8 is the answer.
There you go. Easy peasy. Out of the way, you. Whoop. Of course, there's more. Throwing more gum, which is everywhere. How is he even getting some of this gum? Like, that one was right there. Oh. For whatever reason, my perspective was weird. Anyway.
Rotate the tiles. If X is fine, please.
If you can get this furnace hot enough, it may blast away the remaining debris. Pack objects into the opening, but don't let them overlap. This is another fit-together puzzle. Of course, I love these. Let's see, that kind of looks like the back of his hair. It is. Let's see, and this can go on top of this. What? Oh, I think I had this problem when I initially did this. It attached to the goggles, for reasons. Can you go up here? You can. Now that's more to what I was trying to achieve. Okay. This one looks like your chest here. Your very hairy chest. What's up with that? No, that doesn't fit there. That doesn't fit there. No. Boop. Something connected to something else. I heard. Up. Oh, yep. Decide that it wanted to be there. Okay. No. I was gonna say that might fit right up there. It's kind of hard to see all the pieces. Alright, I bet you something fits in there. Would it be this? No. Not that. Definitely not that. Maybe the fan? The fan? Ha! Come on now. Stop biting me. Ha! And maybe. I can just grab some of this garbage. Stupid. The thing is kind of weird. Let's see. Ha! And I bet you this can. No, it doesn't go there. Maybe the arm goes there? I said maybe the arm? No. Maybe that's the extent of which it goes over. Well, you found something else you wanted to get. I don't see what it was. But you got it. Good job. Anywho, put that right. Alright, it's working just as I had planned. I assure you. That arm still needs to go somewhere. If I can pick it up, pick up the arm. Okay, you don't want to go there. Where do you want to go? I thought it would go there. Alright, let's try to move this into position. Yeah, it should go like right there. There we go. Alright, it's all one piece. Good. Da-da-da! Fire up the furnace. No. Yep. Almost there. So much gum. Don't even need it for puzzle ruse. Too good. But must have it.
Almost there.
Yep. If Nelson could just maneuver three hydraulic lifts into place, he could reach the office door. Drag the arrows to create a command sequence, but beware of bear traps. So this one, we're effectively programming these things to move. Drag and drop the arrows onto the monitor to construct a command line. Each arrow moves the lifts once. Commands execute in the order from left to right, top to bottom, just like a regular program. A lift will be stopped by a wall or by any other barrier. A lift will stop moving when it reaches the goal.
Don't let any lift encounter a bear trap, or it will be destroyed. Alright, well, this is like the perfect puzzle for me, because it is most assuredly programming. That's what it is. Alright, whoop, that's not where it goes. So we'll go up twice. Then we'll go over left, or...
God damn it! Why?
Hmm.
Up there's gum! Gum, 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 gum.
All right, let's try this again. Mm-hmm. All right, so it's the same thing. Up, up, right, up, up. I think that's it. Up, then left, up, up, up. All right, let me see if this works. So we'll look at one first. One will go up twice, then right, then up. Ah, we need to move it. Okay. It's different. Son of a bitch. Okay, forget about that for now. All right. So up, up, right, up, up, right, up. Up, up, right, let's see, up, up, right, up. Perfect. All right, and then you. You go up, up. Can't go right, so it just sticks in place. Can't go up. Can't go up again. Can't go right. It's just stuck there. So we just need to maneuver it up into place. So we take it left one, and then we take it up. One, two, three. One, two, three. I think that'll work. Just going through it again, just to make sure. Do it. Up. Up again. Then right. Then up. Up again. Now we go right. And then up. Perfect. Now let's get number three. Easy peasy. Thankfully, they don't have to be in order, otherwise that'd be really annoying, right? Da-da-da. Just let that develop, because it may be the last time we see it. See a single lock of hair peeking over the table.
Agent
Tethers,
heck of a job. You got that factory back open, and the president is pleased as punch.
Really?
Well, he was never actually aware of the West Wing's eraser shortage. But rest assured, I'm sure he's happy to have not had to strike anything through.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Now back to work.
Sir, about the factory foreman, Isaac Davner.
Doesn't concern us, Tethers. Any missing persons can be handled by local law enforcement.
But...
You did your job. That'll be all.
Oh, okay.
Hey, Tethers. What's a 9-letter word for baffling?
Recondite, sir.
Ha! Thanks a million, Tethers. No wonder you're our star puzzle agent.
Thank you, sir.
You're goddamn right. And that has been Nelson Tethers, Puzzle Agent. I hope that you guys appreciate the charm of this game like I do. It's got its own character, and it's very, very well done in every way I can see. Just great. Just great. It is a damn shame that I miscounted the motherfucking crows, though. Otherwise, we could see the awesome puzzle ending. Perhaps I'll do every puzzle all over again. And then I'll have it for next week. Or maybe I'll just leave it for you folks. Maybe you can find the puzzle that Lethal didn't. All the solutions are there, clearly. Anyway, very fair puzzle design. Very nice art. Very nice writing and acting. Nice sense of humor. Really, there's not much I can say that's bad about this game. I got it for, I think, a couple of dollars. Not really that many. I was inspired to play this game by Ross Scott. You may know of him as the guy behind Freeman's Mine. He did a little piece on this game and Puzzle Agent 2. And it really looked like it was up my alley. So, I took a look at it. And I was pleasantly surprised to see it was an amazing game. And hopefully you did too. Anyway, not much more to say about than that. It certainly did leave itself open to a sequel. I mean, what happened to Danvers there? He was carted away by red little people. What could they be doing to him right now? Are they subjecting his mind to puzzles? Maybe. Would he like that? Who knows? The people of Scoggins are clearly, clearly obsessed with puzzles. Whether they're, you know, Sheriff Bog or Glory, or really anyone. All of them are completely obsessed with puzzaroos. Really, it's a shame that we didn't save Mike. Because it wouldn't have taken that much effort. Or at least, we could have put forth a effort. Apparently it was created with the Telltale tool. I have no idea what that is. But apparently it was the right tool for the job. Melina Annabelle and her Scandinavian heritage apparently inspired much of this game. The National Consortium of Bubblegum Makers, or Manufacturers, is also thanked. And you, yes you, also are pets. Nitro T1. What kind of animal is that? Anyway, we're back at the beginning of Puzzle Agent, and this is free play. So we can see all the puzzles that we solved, and even the one that got away. 10, 10, 10. Seven. Everything else is tens. It's even the point of living. It's even the fucking point of living. Anyway, if the legends are true, if you get perfect answers on all of those, well, then you can get the secret awesome puzzles of justice, and I maybe someday we'll see that. Anyway, this has been Nelson Tethers Puzzle Agent. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you for the next puzzle room.